Hello and welcome back to India Post Live, India's first online live news interactive conversation web portal. I'm Isyam Bhutia. Well, the stage is set for the biggest battle. The Maharashtra Assembly election is due on October 15. Well, this election may well prove to be one of the most acrimonious contests of all time. Just before the elections, we saw BJP and Shiv Sena alliance of 25 years coming falling apart. Similarly, the Congress NCP ties of 15 years also fell apart. Well, who will be the kingmakers this time? To find out more, joining me in this conversation is Vinita Deshmukh, senior journalist. She's calling us from Mumbai. And Vinit Goenka, the co-convener of BJP IT Self. He's joining us from Mumbai. Welcome to India Post Live. Okay, Vinita, ma'am, let me just start with you. You know, you've covered the Maharashtra, you know, extensively. So how would you rate the, you know, NCP Congress government, which have ruled the state for past 15 years? How would you rate their performance of 15 years, ma'am?
Well, it was all about bad governance. And in fact, in the last 5 to 6 years, it has been at the nadir. You know about the Ajit Pawar irrigation scam of 73,000 crore rupees, and there has been no development. There have been so many farmer suicides, and generally, whether it is in the urban areas or the rural areas, people have been very unhappy with this alliance government, which has taken them for a ride, be it water supply, be it irrigation, be it electricity. So it is a general sense of discontentment that is prevailing. And Maharashtra, which was very progressive, has come to be known as the state with the maximum non-governance.
So, ma'am, do you think, you know, the Maharashtra would be the last nail on the coffin for the Congress, since Maharashtra is the last biggest state that Congress is in power at present?
No, actually now, because all the parties have split and there is going to be a five-cornered contest, it is very difficult to predict. Now, the only thing that the candidates are banking on is one is the Modi's, U.S. visit and Make in India, which may percolate into the state. The second thing is the emotional appeal for the Shiv Sena after Balasaheb Thackeray. This is the first election. But at the grassroots level, since the BJP does not have any solid grassroots workers or groups, so there is a probability that in some areas the Congress could gain. Similarly, it is the NCP. So everything is kind of fluid, and I don't think any political pundit also can predict whether the Modi wave is actually going to uplift Maharashtra, which is going to be the single largest party. But the way it seems that only it is the Modi and Balasaheb Thackeray that is prominent now, these two names, on the basis of which these parties are banking on. But there's really nothing that we cannot say that Congress is going to get disseminated. We cannot say that NCP is going to do as badly. So it's a very fluid situation.
Okay, on that note, can I just have Vinit Goenka online?
Yeah.
Yeah, hello, sir. So, sir, you have been on the ground working for these elections. Tell us about, you know, what has been your role in the... Give us a sense of what's happening there.
See, in last 15 years, Maharashtra has traveled backward. Unfortunately, that was that Maharashtra and the people living in Maharashtra, this alliance, not only alliance, Congress, took us back. Businesses have shut down. Entrepreneurs have moved out of Maharashtra, gone to Gujarat, gone to Madhya Pradesh, they're going to Karnataka, but they have left Maharashtra. Jobs are coming down, so is the economy is coming down. There are suicides of farmers. There is, what we say is people are trying to move out of this place because they find other places better than this state. In this challenge, now BJP finds that this is a good time. We should go out, educate the people. Center, we have a full-fledged party government, and we believe that we will be coming in power with absolute majority in Maharashtra.
Okay. So what has been the role of BJP in the opposition in Maharashtra so far?
See, we were there for 15 years in opposition with the alliance. And we have been fighting tooth and nail everything which has been done by this government. Unfortunately, last 15 years, Maharashtra was ruled by NCP and Congress, and also the center was ruled by them. So various projects like the metro project, be it the agricultural policy, the irrigation scam, all these things have taken Maharashtra far behind where it was. Unfortunately, there is no major project which has come up, no ports project has come up, interlinking of the cities has not been done. So this is all what has gone wrong here. Cities like Mumbai, Pune, Nasik have become unsafe cities. Earlier, it was the most safe city in the country.
Okay, sir. So we'll just play these exit poll results which have come out. Just if my producer can just play the exit poll results. Yeah, so there you have it. Exit poll conducted by Mint. So as per the exit poll, so BJP will get 112 seats, Shiv Sena 62, MNS 45, NCP 38, Congress 11, others 19. So the total strength of the assembly is 288. So majority of it is, of course, to BJP, 112. If I can just have Vineet online. Vineet?
I have traveled across in Maharashtra this election. I have personally feel that we can easily go till 150 plus in this election. People want change. People also want to go along with Modi ji. See, if you see the slogan itself, the common man is talking about Chhatrapati ka Ashirwad aur Modi ke saath chalenge.
So you think BJP will get more than 112?
We will be getting more than 144, which is the benchmark. Okay. The target is 145, and I'm sure we'll get more than 150, and we will have an absolute cover.
Okay, so if I can have Vinita ma'am. Yeah, so ma'am, ma'am, are you with us?
Yeah, actually,
yeah.
I couldn't hear what
Mr. Vinit
was saying. Yes.
Yeah, so the exit poll results showed 112 for BJP. Yeah, so the exit poll showed 112 for BJP, but Vinit sir, of course, does not agree with that. With the exit poll, he's saying that, you know, we'll get more, BJP will have more seats than 112.
No, I just think that BJP is being overconfident. And they are all having a big ride on Modi's name. However, in Maharashtra, BJP does not have such a good image because Lok Sabha elections and assembly elections are different. And the first thing that happened in Maharashtra after BJP came to the center is that the first ever RTI activist who was brutally murdered, Mr. Satish Shetty, the CBI was made to close his case in a very, very strange manner, because there have been some nexus between a strong BJP leader and the alleged culprit of this murder. So that is the first, disappointment that the BJP has brought about in Maharashtra. And BJP must realize that unless and until it is sensitive at the ground level, people are not going to vote for them. And they cannot be taken for granted. And this poll has got a very interesting factor that MNS is getting 48 votes. But I just feel that, 48 seats. So, you know, it just may get more because at the grassroots level, Modi's name is not going to work. They will, I think Maharashtra is all set for voting for the candidate. Mm-hmm. And it is going to use nota also in a big way. Because of this split, people have understood the cunningness. Modi came to Maharashtra and he said, I will not say anything against Balasaheb Thackeray because he's keeping his options open so that he can have a trust with them. Therefore, whether it is the NCP, we have had Pune pattern wherein the Shiv Sena, BJP, NCP had got together and ruled the municipal corporation. So Sharad Pawar and Modi also cannot be ruled out. So there is all cunningness going on between all the five major parties, and BJP may even get lesser than what is being predicted by Mint. So I don't think Mr. Vinit Goenka should take the people of Maharashtra for granted. They're very educated and this time they're going to scrutinize and vote.
Okay, Vinit sir, would you like to react to that?
Yeah, certainly. I have a lot of respect for my co-panelist, who she is. But I don't know how much she has traveled in this election. I had an opportunity to talk to activists from my party, volunteers of other parties, and also the common man on the ground. The mood is fantastic, and people want to go along with Modi. People want to go along with Bharatiya Janata Party.
So, Vinita, do you think the Modi wave that worked in the, we saw in the general elections of 2014, do you think that the Modi effect will also have the effect on, you know, Maharashtra Assembly elections?
See, certainly. Modi ji, after coming to power, he probably is the first Prime Minister who has done so many things. He's making, he's communicating with people, and he's doing what is wanted by the people.
Mm-hmm.
And the seriousness is being seen by everybody. He's not trying to communicate with certain channels, but he's trying to communicate with the common man on social media as well. He's the first Prime Minister who started working towards freedom. And the same message and same energy has been felt by every karyakarta, every activist of Bharatiya Janata Party. When I traveled inside Maharashtra, I could see that not only the candidates, but the volunteers who are working with that have the same zeal. Voters have been fed up with NCP and Congress. And also, you have to realize one thing, candidates of BJP have been shortlisted on the basis of their merits. It's an internal democracy which we have got, where we could actually recommend the candidates. So the mood within the party is jovial and fantastic. I have never seen this kind of mood within the party.
Okay, well, we'll just play for you the some of the popular leaders for the assembly election. If my producer can just play the graphics. Yeah. So the most popular leader for this elections, obviously Uddhav Thackeray with 40%, Prithviraj Chavan 18%, Devendra with 12%, Raj Thackeray at 7%, Ajit Pawar 3%, and Narayana Rane with 2%. Okay, Vineet. Yeah, so we just saw the leaders' popular chart, popularity chart. So Uddhav Thackeray has got 40% votes. Do you think that will have any effect?
You have done the reading, and who has done the reading? What was the size of the fan? I'm sure that the Uddhavji has a lot of fan following, but you cannot undermine the fan following of other leaders within Bharatiya Janata Party. Devendra Fadnavis, Vinod Tavre, Khadse, all of them have fantastic following. And they probably, what happens in certain parties, they only have one single leader. We have many, many leaders that we represent, and we have various to go out and talk. So maybe you may see them in different. Say you may say that Devendra ji has 12%, Khadse ji has 15%, Avade ji has 18%, Vineet Goenka has 1%. So collectively, we are far more than any other political party which has only one face to be shown outside.
So you don't want to go by the polls. So okay, talking about the leaders. So who is the candidate, chief minister candidate for the BJP?
You always have to tell the chief minister candidate. We can always decide by the elected representative. Has Congress come out with the president candidate? They never came out with the prime minister candidate. They never came out with who will be the chief minister candidate. Does the NCP has a chief minister candidate? Shiv Sena has a chief minister candidate, or MNS has a chief minister candidate. But this is not relevant in Maharashtra. Maharashtra, the topic which is relevant is the GDP of Maharashtra has gone down. The per capita income of the common man in Maharashtra has gone down. The law and order situation is down. There is something called as governance in this state.
Sir, but sir, Vineet sir, BJP has had the tradition of announcing the CM candidate before the elections. But so far for these elections, you haven't done that. So are you feeling shaky, nervous in any way that you've not announced?
Let me correct you. We were the first person to announce chief minister candidate as Mumbai ji as the candidate. Unfortunately, we lost him in a very unprecedented, unseen situation. Now, after that, we have just come to terms, understand that, and to see a leader whom we have been nurturing and whom we have been following, whom we have been loving. Actually, all of a sudden, to tell me to announce somebody, it is difficult. We have various people. See, we are fortunate that we are fortunate to have various people who can take the leadership. Does other party have server? If I ask certain parties, they don't even have second guy to come and speak on the dais. I have so many people who can become chief ministerial candidate.
Mm-hmm. So, sir, how relevant is the Marathi pride for your party? Who is your Marathi strong leader?
So many people, you see, Mr. Khadse, Fadnavis, Tavre, Dada Patel, in Mumbai, we have got. So we have got all of us.
Okay, Vinita ma'am.
I'll just complete my sentence.
Okay, sir.
Marathi pride is one thing, we are not standing by that. We have been talking about this nation first, is second in the how our youngsters will get, how our sisters will get. We are talking about up to take Maharashtra, all Maharashtras and see. We are not talking about separatist movement in the religious space. For my vote at least is relevant. We would like to make Maharashtra the top has been what Madhya Pradesh has got. We would like to bring back a track where everybody in Maharashtra is safe and gets insecure. Give jobs to the hands which we have legitimate. So let us come out of this emotional appeal. This person should come out. We have to job for them.
Okay.
If you've seen a Maharashtra going out to other state and doing a job. Whereas we have all the resources what is needed to be a complete state, to be a complete independent come out.
Okay. Yeah. I'll just get back to you, sir. Vinita, ma'am, you've been waiting to, wanting to say something, yeah? Ma'am?
Yeah, ma'am. Actually, ma'am, I can't hear much of what Mr. Goenka is saying. But what I'd like to say is that BJP has no face for a chief minister in Maharashtra. In fact, Maharashtra is in a big scoop because none of the faces of any political parties is really popular. Now, this is, you know, like in Marathi, there is a saying that amongst the handicapped cows, a calf with all four legs is more popular. Similarly, there is just no face in Maharashtra, which is popular. Uddhav Thackeray does not have the charisma of Balasaheb Thackeray. Raj Thackeray has the charisma, but he did not deliver. He merely made promises, just keeps doing andolans and keeps withdrawing. In BJP, Mr. Nitin Gadkari may be a union minister, but he is not at all popular in Maharashtra. If you talk about Tharse or any other leaders, they are upcoming leaders, but they are not the face of Maharashtra. And so BJP is in a very big soup, and only Modi is the face in Maharashtra, unfortunately. Modi is not going to work. We saw it in the bipoles in other states. Maybe he may work to a certain extent with his Make in India and US trip. But honestly speaking, Maharashtra has no face for a chief ministership. And that is why, like I told earlier, the entire situation is fluid. And there could be many surprises. There's going to be horse trading. There is going to be BJP and Shiv Sena coming together, BJP, NCP, Shiv Sena. You never know what is going to happen. It's very difficult to predict. And Mr. Goenka just is trying to be confident because he belongs to be the BJP, but he knows that it is not so in Maharashtra.
Okay, ma'am. Vinita, ma'am. So, last question before I wrap up the show. Do you think the majority that Vinita was talking about of 140, 140 above, do you think it's a distant dream for BJP?
Yeah, certainly. I feel it's a distant dream, but it is not. It is possible that BJP could come out as a single largest party, followed by Shiv Sena. That is what is followed by MNS. This is the picture that I can assess. I'm not an expert, but I don't think BJP will come with a majority. Both have made a mistake. BJP wants to show that since we have won in India, you know, we should go single. Shiv Sena is saying that after Balasaheb Thackeray, it is an emotional thing for them. So they should, they would come as a single largest party. Both are, you know, having egos. But at the end of it, I can tell you, since Modi did not speak anything against Balasaheb, he's kept his options open. So it could be a BJP SS truck. At the moment, it seems that.
Okay, yeah, thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much for joining us on India Post Live. Vinit, sir.
We are very confident we'll be meeting again. So there's just 8 days left. So don't worry, I'll come back with my chief ministerial candidate and also a government in Maharashtra.
Sir, last question before I wrap up the show. Will you tie up with MNS after the polls?
I'm not aware of this.
Oh, okay, sir. Okay, thank you, sir. Thank you for joining us on India Post Live, sir. Thank you, Vinita, ma'am. Thank you. Well, that's all we have for you on this show. Send us your feedback and comments on www.indiapostlive.com. You can also send us your tweet at hashtag tag India Post Live or @IndiaPostLive. You can also go to our Facebook page and post your comments there. Thank you for watching the show.